Hello everyone and welcome to the trailer launch of Paava Kadhaigal from Netflix. We have a distinguished panel of guests here. I'm going to begin from the extreme end where we have Ashish Dua, who's one of the producers of the film. Ronnie Screwvala couldn't be here. He's another producer. Next we have Vignesh Sivan, who's directed one of the four segments. We have Sudha Kongra, who's directed another segment. We have Gautam Vasudev Menon, who's directed another segment. We have Srishti Arya, who's from Netflix. And we have Vetri Maran, who's directed a segment as well. So what took you so long to come to the South with content? Were you trying to test out the waters in the North first and then come down, or how did it happen?
What we like to do is to come for the creator first approach. So I guess it was waiting for the right stories. And we got lucky because if you see the distinguished panel of directors that we have, we wanted to make sure that when we come here, we do this with the right stories in the right ethos.
And Ashi, how did, once you said that we want to do this, right, we want to make, was the first thought to make an anthology film, or did you say, let's just see what we can do, and then the anthology fell into place?
So actually, I had met Vetri sir and Gautam sir in 2014 when I'd made a film called Bombay Talkies to do an anthology in Tamil then. And at that point, we couldn't pull it off because of the whole theatrical bit and being able to raise money to do it down south. We ended up doing it in Hindi. But I always wanted to do something in Tamil with them. And when we found an opportunity with Netflix, and Netflix was interested in doing it, that's when I went back to them and I said, now is a good time. And now, you know, we have a platform like Netflix, which makes content easy for people to view worldwide, and you know, it's breaking all the language barriers. So that's when it all started again. I went back to them, we restarted the conversation, and I was very lucky to for filmmakers to want to do this.
So Vetri and Gautam, when she first approached you, you said 2014?
Yes.
What was your initial reaction?
I was very excited, and I really tried to, you know, meet everybody, and I met Gautam, I asked Amir, and I asked Venkat Prabhu, all of us. So we were thinking of ways to make that happen, and I really wanted to do that. And when it didn't happen, I was very disappointed, actually, okay, to be frank. And then when this came again, I was very excited, and I thought I should do it.
Gautam?
Yeah, I remember the meeting, and it was supposed to be love stories initially, and I really just jumped at it. Till Vetri came around and changed it to what it is now. So,
but that's fascinating. I mean, I think you should pursue that at some point. You know, one movie being directed by four distinct filmmakers, you know, with distinct voices. That would be very interesting.
Yeah. So that's the idea when we started. That was the idea. So we thought a journey of an aspiring filmmaker, youngster from a small town or a village in Madurai, comes to Chennai, his struggles to get into the industry, and then he becomes an AD, and then he becomes a filmmaker. That journey we wanted to capture, like in four segments.
How did this particular arrangement of directors come into play? So you said you spoke to Vetri first.
Yes. Yeah. Like I said, Vetri and Gautam sir, I'd met them in 2014, and I wanted to restart the conversation with them. I definitely always want a female voice, and she was. She heard us out and she was like, okay, I'll do this. And through all of them, I found Vignesh. And we met, and I, you know, he's got this young voice, and he's the new, you know, I hadn't seen any of his work before I'd met him. So after I met him, I went back, I saw some of his work, and was very excited to have found him in the midst of all of this as well, yes.
So Vignesh, we have to ask you this. What was the reaction when somebody came and said, you're making a movie with Vetri Maran, Gautam Menon, and Sudha Kongra?
See, obviously, I couldn't have asked for anything better than this, because I've tried to assist Gautam sir. Wanted to become his assistant director for so many years I've tried, but then later, I was supposed to work in his production for a film, and then we all look up to Vetri sir's work, and then even Sudha ma'am, also I've worked with all of them in, you know, some part of my life. So. Being sitting with them together now is like, it is almost a dream come true for me.
So Vetri, Gautam said that this was supposed to be love, that zone, till you change it around. So can you tell us about the changing around and how that came about?
Yeah, I okay, when Ashi told, let's do an anthology, I immediately said, see, principally, I am in, let's do it. Then it was, she said, let's do love stories. First it was Chennai stories, stories around Chennai, and then lust stories, like what they had done in Hindi. And I said, it became love stories. And I said, see, all the, I'm a mainstream filmmaker, all my films, whether I want it or not, will have a love story in it. Either the love story is the primary one or the secondary one. We have love stories and we keep doing love stories. And we're bored of doing love stories. When I have a platform like Netflix and I want to do a film, I thought that we should push ourselves a little outside our comfort zone. While we were discussing, then Ashi said that this is there is an idea that we are working in Telugu, which is based on honor killings and pride. And this is a good idea. If this is it, I am in. If it's love story, then please let me out. I will not do it. I said.
But Vetri, you should make a love story at some point.
No, I will, but not in
he owes me. He owes me one lust story now.
Yeah, lust, that's even better.
Yes.
No, actually, Vetri on the call said, if it's love stories, I don't want to be in it because I don't think I can make a love story. So you guys go ahead. And we didn't want to lose Vetri, so which is why we said, okay, what do you want? And then the discussion turned it around to honor killing and, you know, sin stories and all that. So we decided, okay, we don't want to lose Vetri on this, so that's how we got. And I'd like to differ from what you said. Just said. We didn't want to lose you, so we changed it around. So.
Now, all four of you, and let's begin with you, Sudha, once you decided that honor, pride in one's surroundings, you know, that kind of a thing comes into place, like, I want each one of you to answer this. Did any of you consciously try to say, I don't want to make a movie, I just want to tell a story, but I want to avoid the activism trap? Was that a concern for you?
So that's always my thought. A film is a film, and if there is activism which is beneath all that layered, so be it. But I didn't start out to make an activist film. It was a story
right.
that I wanted to tell. It touched my heart. I mean, I was sobbing when I read it. So I called the writer and I told him I want to do this. This story has to be told because I was crying. I sent him a selfie at 4:30 in the morning, like a crazy person, saying this is what the story has done to me. I have to say it. So that was one. Secondly, when we were talking on a killing, there isn't even one person talking about what I've talked about in
right.
the film. I've been wanting to understand because my understanding of it is very less. And I wanted to see if I was sensitive enough to grasp what these people are feeling. So that's how it started.
Right, right. Vignesh?
When we are touching a topic like this, it's not very, it is a sensitive topic. And from my experience, like, I'm not exposed to something in real life like that. We live in cities and things like that. But I wanted to understand it first. So I started reading, and then I spoke to a couple of directors, my friends. And then I came to know how sensitive it is. And then, but I didn't want to make it in a, like, you know, how it's regularly made. I wanted to give my style of treatment to it, how it can be watchable. Most of the times, content like this is very, you know, hard hitting, and it's very difficult to watch. I mean, it's very more on the emotional side. So I thought, instead of, like, you know, let it not just be tragical, maybe give it a better treatment. So that was the first challenge which I had for my own self. And then I started writing with that note. Okay, make it a little, like, you know, I can't say pleasant, but then it has to also be entertaining at some level.
Gautam?
I struggled with it for a bit. I think I went into production at the fag end. Like, everybody had made their films. So Vetri was trying to help me with taking a sort of a leaf from his story forward, you know, and we discussed that idea. And I knew what Vetri was making, and it seemed so powerful by itself. So I thought, whatever I do will really not, you know, live up to what Vetri has done. And then Sudha suggested a book, like a novella for me, and that seemed too sort of vast to film in that time, and, you know, the money involved and all that stuff. So wanted to be within, I know it's a lot of work and all, but wanted to be within my, you know, comfort zone. And then I put myself into it in that sense. And I just told that line. I didn't want to, and I picked from what generally the society perceives
right.
from, you know, a moment like that. So, and I think I stayed on that line. I had to convince Simran, the actor, to sort of I said it might go either way. People might perceive it in this way or that way. So she was very keen, and I think that's all it needed. And
either way as in?
As in, if you've seen the film, there is a line, you know, which I could have easily crossed with the mother actually going ahead to do something that,
okay,
you know, is not really done, right? So she was hoping I wouldn't go that way, but she was keen to be in the film.
You mean plot-wise?
Yeah, plot-wise. Yeah. So it's not, it was not in my zone, okay, but then I put myself into it, yeah.
Vetri?
I wanted to tell a story of a father and a daughter, and their emotional journey. Like, it's just, it started off for me with the daughter and the father talking. The daughter is locked inside the room. The father is standing outside the room. Through the window, their conversation. So that whole idea was to have this conversation for 30 minutes.
Okay.
So that is how it started. But then I started adding things, and I just, it just fleshed itself out to what it is now. But my thought, I should say unconscious thought, was to have a microscopic view on those last moments. Someone whom you had given all your love and your hopes, and to see them live a long life in the name of pride, honor, or whatever it is, like what you end up doing to them. Like, you know, I just wanted to have a microscopic view on the pain that is involved in everybody. So I thought, if that could be magnified, if that could be shown, I would have started a discussion, initial discussion. So that is the starting point for me to tell that.
Pavam is sin. I mean, I would have thought that, you know, you would have gone along the lines of honor rather than a... So what made you say that sin is the word that best encapsulates these four stories?
Gautam was talking about this. This, all the four films, doesn't exactly categorize as honor killing.
Right.
So it has various ways of, or aspects of, various aspects and understandings of that term.
Right.
Honor and respect in those characters' respective worlds. So it is better to not brand it, and you don't need to categorize it as just honor killing stories. It
right.
is not honor killing stories alone.
Yeah.
It has got more to it.
Yeah.
And also, that sin element is finer, no? Like finer in the sense it is ingrained in everybody, in every deed and every act. You could have that element. And Gautam's story is the best way of looking at it, you know. It could be this or that.
Right.
So everybody's choice, the choice that the mother in his film took, the father in that film took, that is the choice that every father and mother should take. That is what makes this title interesting.
Right. Sudha, you were saying something?
Encompasses all our films best. Sin is something that's there in every one of our stories.
Right.
More than the honor that also exists, but this is
something that
it's very hard hitting, the sin part of it. It's very,
from a non-director perspective, so you're looking at things from so many perspectives,
yeah,
and you're looking at them, you know, if you just box it down to just making it about one thing, I think you're doing a disservice, because there is a personality of every director. There is a point of view of every director. And we've been fortunate enough to get it holistically. So it's about, like Sudha ma'am and Gautam sir were saying, right? It's about how it encompasses across. Also, to my mind, and my limited creative knowledge would be that how we, you know, what is sin?
Right.
And from whose point of view is it? So I think it was a beautiful title that came up from the directors.
So,
in the thing about the title also, ironically, the directors wanted an English title. So Netflix insisted on a Tamil title. I'm happy that
they insisted. So what would your English title have been?
Sin Stories.
Sin Stories?
Yeah.
Okay, Stories of Sin, yeah. So I'm going to put you directors on the spot and ask you to name the one film above everyone else. So obviously you cannot pick your film, but we'll begin with Vignesh.
okay, I don't want to be diplomatic and boring. So I'll go with Vetrimaaran sir's film.
Okay.
I liked this film.
Okay.
Because it was, it explains what it is, like, you know, for someone who's watching from somewhere, like, what is honor killing? Is it so gruesome? I mean, is it so tragical? You know, it just gives you the, an explanation of what it is and how hard it is. So I love this film. With everyone's film, every film is unique, as
yeah.
you know.
Yeah.
But if I have to pick one, I'll pick Vetri's.
Yeah. Sudha?
Very difficult, but I think what I couldn't have done and he's done very well was Vicky's film. So it was a very different take. I didn't know how he could have made something so different from what I've been thinking of it, or at least they were in the same graph. This was totally different, so I liked that.
Okay.
So for me, I think I don't want to be diplomatic and political like he said, but I want to say that I actually loved all the three films because Vetri is stark, and I felt that too while watching his film. So would I want to watch something and be disturbed? Yes, sometimes yes, I would like to. But it like she said it, and like Vignesh said, it shows you exactly what that moment
thing
is all about,
yeah.
you know, and it's stark in that sense. It leads up to that, and the whole film is that, you know. So, and I don't want to reveal too much also here. In Sudha's film, this trans people angle comes in a very beautiful way. The way Kalidas has performed, the way she's gone into that space, and she's, you know, those characters just come alive for you. And like she's mentioned about Vignesh's film, it's a completely different take on a killing. And if you can, you actually laugh and smile through that film, but it's also dark in that sense, you know. So I think he's really exploited that angle really well. So I have to pick from all these three films and say it really, and the whole film as such,
right.
the
right.
anthology as such, completely worked for me. Yeah.
Okay, I'll have to say, I really like the way Sudha's film starts. It starts with so much of confidence and fine thing, and I really like Gautam's the way he had finished the film. I feel the takeaway of this anthology stays in his climax. I feel that way.
All of you, what is the primary difference apart from the fact that you can pick a subject and go any way you want with it on TV? What is the change, was it liberating to kind of, you know, do something in this format, or was it more challenging because you have a time limit, or rather a rough time limit to go through? What was that like? Did you find that there was something, what I'm trying to ask is, what are the pros and the cons of this versus theatrical?
An anthology or OTT?
Anthology.
OTT feature, OTT anthology is different.
Yeah.
See, I think people like Sudha and I are not made for anthologies. Gautam is ideally suited for anthology because he's such a beautiful sport. Because Sudha wants her film to be the first film. I want my film to be either the first film or the last film. That thing is there. He's like the best, you know. See, you don't get to see people like Gautam. I've never seen such a team player like Gautam. So it's for people like him. It suits very well, though the experience of making a film with your contemporaries or people whom you have always worked like, you know, as friends, you've worked on various levels. Now making films together is an experience, but anthology is a challenging task.
Right. They always say that it's tougher to write a short story compared to a novel because you have to. Like, really, did you feel that while you were scripting this?
I normally don't write, so.
Any of you others, Gautam,
no,
Sudha?
For me, it's good to get away with half an hour, 40 minutes. Right. Problem starts after 40 minutes for me. So
yeah.
I get out of 40 minutes and I'm happy.
Second half.
Yeah, always.
Sudha?
Actually, I didn't find it easy at all because when I write, there's a middle, there is a beginning, there's an end, and it's like, I don't know, I take my time to work it out, the whole emotions, and I crush all that into a short film format. So what I was doing was, I was doing what I would do on a feature in 30 minutes. I wasn't treating it like a separate format. So that became pretty challenging for me.
I enjoyed it. it was a little challenging also because I had many characters in the film, so I didn't. I wanted to, you know, give proper endings for all the characters. It shouldn't just pop out and, you know, go missing towards the end. So that was kind of, and I also wanted to give a proper ending for the film. Like, you know, films, concepts like this, towards the end we tend to give a very abstract ending or an open ending. But what I want to say, like what should happen,
right,
something like that. I just wanted to have that little edge of the film, like what am I trying to say. So I had that small, space. So to bring in all those things into 30 minutes was a little tough only.
It's not exactly 30,
we've all exceeded,
right,
the limit a little bit.
But 27.
Then. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Ma'am is the first rank.
No,
student.
Because they put rules. No, they put rules and I seem to be the only one who's following it. Like,
yeah,
you know, I'll call Ashi like some 100 times. I say, listen, this is going to 33 minutes. What do I do? So then Vicky will say, it's okay. Mine will be 25 minutes. So you take my 5 minutes. So this is how we were like deciding on the length.
Vicky, you spoke about the characters. Let's talk about the casting, right? Because none of the cast could be here. Well, let's begin with Shrishti and Ashi. Did you have any criteria regarding the cast, or did you just leave it completely up to the directors and say, you pick whoever you want?
No, we left it completely up to the directors, and we went through all those discussions with each of them.
Okay.
I think it was very special. I think that freedom is the most special aspect of this film. We just cast who we wanted to, we told the story we wanted to in the way that we wanted to. So I thank you, Netflix and Ashi.
Vignesh?
Yeah, we didn't have any pressure actually. Like, you know, there was no interference in the script or the casting or maybe any aspect. I was under the impression that they might streamline every film into, you know, into a particular area or something like that.
Right.
But then there was absolutely no pressure, and that gives so much of liberty also, like to cast whoever you want. I've tried my I've went very weird, wacky about the casting. No need for any pressure. Just whoever I've always wanted to work. Love the way Kalki acts. Like, you know, so I just wanted to cast her. So that gives that freedom, and it shows in the movie also. So that's what I felt. Thank you again.
Gautam and Vetri, did you ever with the others too? But did you guys ever toy with maybe casting like one, you know, quote unquote big name, just to kind of, you know, or was the whole idea to free yourself from working with the idea of big names? Was that the attraction?
Yeah, I didn't look at it like that. I wrote this at some point, and I think the minute I finished writing, I thought Simran should be in this film. And she was my first choice, the only choice. And I called her up and she said, yeah, I'd love to do it. And I gave her a narration. I had somebody else in mind to play, opposite her. Last minute, that didn't come through. So I just went ahead and...
You're a big name, Gautam. I think you can say that.
I was a little uncomfortable in the sense I don't think like an actor. So, but Simran was there and then the team was there. So I think, I just figured out from all their films that you need somebody to sort of stand out a bit. Like his film has Sai Pallavi and Prakash Raj, right?
Right.
So, and I knew the cast of the other films. Vicky and I were discussing right through. So I just thought one name, which I thought was Simran, and that was it for me, yeah.
For me, I'll have to say, add one more thing to this whole, the difference between mainstream and making a film for OTT. Unconsciously, I've always had a big pressure on my back. Like, I did not realize that until I was shooting for this one. You feel that there's someone like, you know, pushing you down, pressing you down, which is the mainstream acceptance and the market requirements. With this film, I did not have any of that. And I really felt so relaxed. It was like a vacation for me, like shooting for this film, thinking about this film. It was like vacation for me. Of course, the whatever that was inside, the content, the pain, the angst, but the other external pressures, external aspect, that was not there. And for the cast part of it, I really had big names cast in it. Normally, I don't have so many big names in my films.
Yeah.
This one had Prakash Raj and Sai Pallavi.
Yeah.
Both of them have done and are doing big work. So for me, I thought that they both, being the father and the daughter, would add to whatever I have written or whatever I have not written.
Right.
So I thought I should bring them together, and that worked.
Yeah, so big names in the sense, they are big names, but they are powerful actors also.
Yeah, yeah.
Sometimes
yeah,
big names are not powerful.
Big names is an unfair term, I know, but what I mean is starry, you know, that kind of thing.
So some of the stars are not great actors, I'm saying. But here you have somebody like a Prakash Raj and Sai Pali who are like, you forget their names, you know, once you watch his film. You forget, and you just go into that zone by itself.
Right.
And then, like Vetri was saying, the pressure of writing something for the audience, you know, is not there at all here. You're not languid about your filmmaking for sure. You're not just, you know, filming something. But every shot is constructed the way that emotion should be conveyed. And you're not thinking of edit length. You're not thinking of, will the audience be, you know, restless in the
lag
theater.
Lag
irukka. Lag irukka. There's nothing like that.
Vetri, this is so much less stress. Isn't this a natural way to go? I mean, just keep making movies for Netflix.
See, there are certain films that needs the spectacle of the big screen. And those, and also really, really big budget. Of course, Netflix has the budget to, you know, give and put that vision.
She's smiling.
Yeah, she has the budget.
I think once the movie's out and the power of the service comes out and you see how we are, because we're out in 190 countries on the same day and date, right? We have over 195 million subscribers for Netflix. So the reach of it, And the understanding, I think that's only, I'm just waiting for all these creators to come. I mean, Ashi is the one of the most supportive producers that you can get because she's actually seen how it works.
One of the things that the teaser gives us is that this is in a relatively raw and rooted zone, which might be a little different from what Netflix India has been doing with the Hindi films, which is love stories, and which is not to say that they're not rooted or anything like that, but what I mean is it's a raw zone. How did both of you, you know, enjoy that aspect of the story, that we were getting into a, you know, this kind of a zone, which must have, I mean, it's a bit of a new thing for a non-Tamil audience, because in Tamil cinema, there is a lot of violence. There is a lot of rawness. There are many stories set in villages. There are many, you know, in fact, Gautam would be probably one of the, outliers in Tamil cinema. Whereas in Hindi cinema, there are a lot of people like Gautam who keep making stories in a thing. And Hindi cinema doesn't step beyond a certain zone very often. So how did you find the change, from that to this?
I have to differ on that because I think that change is already happening. And there are a lot of Hindi filmmakers also that are in that zone and are making films that are rooted and homegrown stories are actually that are connecting with people. And for us, it was more like going with the vision of the filmmaker. We have faith in the filmmakers that are there who are doing this film with us. And once you talk about the subject and you talk about the story that you want to tell, then you have to tell it as it is.
Right.
And if that's how they envision it and that's how it should be told. And people will connect with stories like that because this is our country that we live in. And these are our stories and this is actually happening in the country.
Right.
So even though it might not be happening to you, but you know that this is the country you live in and stories like this happen. And we completely went with the vision of our filmmakers. And that's what Netflix is amazing at doing, backing the vision of the filmmakers and giving them that freedom. And, you know, like they said, that they felt that freedom while making it. And I'm sure when people watch it, they will see that with the content. Yeah.
You know, Tamil cinema has always been like very luminous. And it's important for us to bring it in its authentic form.
Right.
I think across, if you see, we also try to focus a lot on diversity.
Right.
I mean, I always say that whatever mood you're in, if you come onto Netflix, you should find something that's going to engage with you in the mood that you're in. So there are times when you want to come and watch something that's, you know, very easy breezy, that you don't have to really focus on. And then there are times when you want to come in onto the service and be really like, you know, mesmerized or just completely pulled into another world. So that, I mean, I myself sometimes go back and watch really lean back things I've seen before. And then there are times when I want to learn something new, whether it's on a docu or just a point of view of a filmmaker. So I would say that we've tried, even if you see like a film like Choked or you see Bulbul or you see Kadi Kuhi, just down this year, we've been fortunate enough to have a lot of filmmakers who've given us their stories. And so whether you have something more mainstreamy like say a Guilty or you go across to a Gunjan Saxena or if you look at Raat Akeli Hai, or for that matter, I mean, like we just had Ludo on, but that was more opportunistic. I feel very rooted in a different place, but we do try to stay true to the vision of the filmmaker, like Ashi was saying. But most importantly, like the story told in the way that it should be told.
No, and also, I mean, I think all of you would agree with it. When we, you know, earlier, when there was this whole thing of, you know, people watched it for a second time, a third time, you know, you still went to theaters and watched. But now I think that's the second and third times happen on, you know, on the platform. So the same movie that had one kind of resonating, you know, that resonated one way in the theaters is now being consumed in a different way. So that's really interesting of how kind of a thing. So Ashi and Srishti, how would, I mean, is it too early to say, or do you already have like plans about how to take this forward in terms of, this is one film that you've made, one anthology. Do you guys, you know, have plans for the future, or are you just waiting to see how this plays out and slowly see, you know, take plans after that? So
I'll let Srishti answer that.
So we look forward to anything that Ashi wants to do because, okay, you know, it's been such a long association, you know, at Netflix.
The thing with anthologies is you get to work with such incredible filmmakers in one film. I mean, if I had to work with all four of them in separate films, it would have taken like 6 years or 7 years. Or I don't even know if it would have been possible. An audience gets to see all these filmmakers do one film together and have different perspectives on the same subject and,
right,
and completely different storytelling, you know, formats in the way they make their stories or the way they tell their stories. It's interesting for us as creators, and I'm sure it's interesting for audiences to watch all these filmmakers come together to tell the same story, you know, on the same subject.
So I'm going to actually take us back to the first question that you asked me. Why now and why this? And I think going forward, we're going to try and stay true to that,
right,
and say that we're going to wait for the right content and creators who are like, you know, unable to hold back but want to come out with something that they want to say. We do have another anthology called Navarasa, which would be coming out after this in Tamil specifically. But we're really looking forward to take, you know, Tamil cinema to the world.
Right.
We're trying to make sure, like, even a film like Akuni, which was, you know, something that came more northeast, are getting representation, that we should also be watched not just by our own, you know, fellow Indians, but also, like, the rest of the world, and bring the brilliance of these filmmakers to everyone.
Yes, on that note, you know, thank you so much for bringing this great story. Yeah, applause.